everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And today we're going to do part two of our fall garden. Behind me, you will see our free library. This was one of our big projects for the summer, and it turned out beautifully. We've had a lot of nice comments about it. Several times weekly, we find people that are coming to visit.
Oh my,
yeah. They leave things. I see we have some advertising for churches in here. Yep. But we have a variety of books for adults and for children.
Yeah. Well, it's amazing to see the number of families that have stopped and kids on their bikes and families. I still remember the girl, the teenage girl, reading to her little brother sitting on this bench.
Yes, it was lovely. And now that school's going, of course, we don't see a whole lot of children, but it's kind of nice because it's like surrounded by a forest of cannas.
Well, you have a few things still blooming here.
Yes. Yes, we do. These are our annuals, and then we have our perennials and then our bulbs. Now, the bulbs here, here, and here will all have to be dug up, but that's
well,
okay.
Well, same on this side, too.
Yep. So they'll be ready for next year.
Yeah. It is a nice little pretty annual accent too. It's always nice to have annuals and perennials.
Well, the annuals give you a lot of color instantly.
Yes.
But you also see we still have fresh dill.
Ah, yes. We can never have enough dill.
No, never. Now, early in the summer, we planted a few wildflower seed packages in here and a canna. But you can see because it was so shaded by the trees, even though it's on the south side of the house, they didn't do a lot, but now we're getting to see them because things are going down and we get to see more. We had some cannas here, but you can see the grasses have done wonderfully this year and they've kind of taken over. That's okay.
We're going to have to tie these grasses up.
Yes. Or have somebody make us some really sturdy cages to put them in.
Something.
Mm-hmm, because I would hate to get rid of them. I mean, they're beautiful, but they do take up a lot of space. Another fascinating non-invasive buckthorn is this fine line. I don't remember it last year losing its leaves like this, but I guess it would. Why not? Plus, it's been very dry, so we'll see. Hopefully, it'll be back next year. Also, we have more liatris.
Oh, golly.
And as I always do with liatris, I like to collect the seeds. And this time, I'm just going to sprinkle them right around here and get more of them next year. Here you go. Now, I'm sure some of them will be eaten by mice and voles and maybe squirrels if they get desperate, but there's
birds?
Enough. And probably birds, yes.
I mean, you are growing quite a hedge here now on this berm.
Yes.
And again, for viewers who have just maybe found us, these berms were not made with soil. And these are, I'd say, 20 foot wide now.
Yes.
And at their peak, they're probably at least a couple of feet above, and some are even taller than that. And this is all from leaf mulch.
Right.
No soil.
Piling leaves on here in the fall. Now, last year we had a butterfly garden here. And we put in many, many seeds. Some of them came back. So we decided, well, this year we'll just add a few more seeds and see what happens. See if we like the results. Well, we really didn't. I mean, there's some, obviously, the black-eyed Susans were fine, and some of the zinnias.
Yeah, you had a lot of small little, I don't know, annuals, perhaps?
I don't know what they were, but then also we have the very tall cosmos that always loves to reseed itself. So this is an area for next year that we're thinking of redoing and perhaps adding something more permanent. I just wanted to show you that I did let these mullein grow for Richard. And that one's way taller than me.
That's got to be close to 9 foot tall.
But you can see it's full of seeds that are going to grow many, many more. Look at that. They're like poppy seeds.
Yeah, well, look what you did to my other two. I mean, no, you just chopped those
stop
babies.
Them. Look.
Yeah, they're stunted now. Boy, oh, boy.
Well, they'll grow again.
Yeah, right.
Another one of Rick's favorites that is also invasive are these Chinese lanterns. Now, we purposely let all of them grow this past year, and because of the weather being so dry, we never sprinkle over on this area. This is the east side, and I think they just kind of collapsed.
I think you stomped them
dryness.
Down while I wasn't looking.
No, I didn't.
You were probably rolling around in there. Look at that.
There will be a lot of seeds in there because each one of these little lanterns. Has seeds in it. See, I think there's something wrong with them because they shouldn't be all that gooey.
No.
Let me see how this one looks. This one feels better. Yeah, that's how it should look. So maybe it was just a bad year for Chinese lanterns. Not China lights.
Oh, that's something
lanterns.
Else that is pretty amazing. If you get a chance, Google the words China lights.
Milwaukee.
In Milwaukee. Oh, what an amazing sculptural garden at the Berner. In fact, we're going to be volunteering there shortly.
Yes.
Help people find their way.
But we still have some that are standing up tall.
Are you going to stomp these down too?
No, I think I'll pick these.
Oh, you're going to pick those?
Uh-huh. I will. And we have our Autumn Joy sedum, which gives the bees again and the butterflies that are still around here a place to still find some nectar. This is tickweed. This is another one of Rick's favorites. This just reseeds itself every year. And
well, it's like a yellow carpet. And I like the fullness of it, just like I did the fullness of the Chinese lanterns before you stomped them down.
Now, come fall, the ferns are done. But because it's been so dry for the last month or so, they are done suddenly because they're very dry and, you know, not as much sun. So they'll be back in the spring. But for right now, you know, they don't look really nice.
Well, there is no physical way we can water this entire property anymore. I mean, basically, our house is surrounded by gardens. This happens to be the east side of our property and the east berms. But
and that's fine because the plants that we have out here are tough.
Look at your trumpet vine.
Now there is a perfect example of toughness. That trumpet vine blossomed this year. It is in total shade most of the day, except for the very, very first part of the day when the sun comes up. Then it gets full sun. The rest of the day it's in shade and it's blossoming. It's growing as happy as can be. So weather doesn't affect everything. Now you can see behind me is one of our Macintosh apples that we are doing an espalier training for it. We cannot cut it at this point. We won't be trimming it until late next winter, early spring. But I'd say this apple tree is very happy. Hopefully next year we won't get a frost right when it's blossoming and we'll actually get some apples from it.
No, you've got
its
the same thing
partner
on this side.
Over here is not anywhere near as large.
No, and it's in
and
I'd
this
say
one's
more
in
sun.
Full sun, right? Yeah. And this one's in partial shade. Which leads me to believe that maybe the soil underneath is different or something.
Yeah.
But
well, this one is definitely
this one
happy.
It's very happy, yes. And now look at here, daisies. One of the first things to blossom in the spring. I cut these back after they blossom because I did not want seeds all over everywhere, but they're fine down here at the end of the driveway. And now they've rebloomed and given us, again, something for the pollinators to have for food and also for us for beauty. We're now in our east driveway, the main driveway, and you are looking south. This is our snake willow tree that gives a lot of shade, but a lot of it's dappled shade. And as a result, the things under it still can grow and grow nicely. Our Joe Pye weed over there is going to seed. That had a very nice display earlier. Behind us is, or right here, is our fleece plant that is at its end but still green. Variegated phlox over there. And the two taller bushes there are our tree peonies that blossom beautifully this spring.
And all of your hostas this year were really full of blossoms.
Yes.
I mean, again, because of the wet spring and the wet summer, they were amazing.
The hostas were really happy this year, yes. And we have a bunch of different kinds. So, but you can see also that my elephant ears that I have planted here and there and everywhere also, while they were slow to come in, they are now doing lovely. And it gives a nice background to the chrysanthemums that are still blooming. Here's a hosta that is still blooming.
Yeah, amazing.
Again, probably a little later because it was in more shade. This was our prairie coneflower, which went on and on and on with its blossoms. They are just beautiful. And there's a bumblebee still enjoying it. The birds will love these heads. As you can see, they've already been after the heads.
It's nice to have native plants.
Yes, and these snapdragons and nasturtium think they are native plants because they reseed themselves and seem to be coming up every year. Maybe it's because it's been warmer over the winters. Maybe it's because of the snow we pile here. I don't know, but...
Oh, look, you have some more liatris seeds to drop around.
Oh, really?
As if you didn't have enough.
Now, these grow in shade. I'm guessing that's why they are so...
Contorted?
Contorted. They always seem to be this way on this, right here, under this tree. So, they do enjoy sun better than shade, but they will blossom in the shade. We're going to end part two right here for now, and stay tuned for part three. If you enjoyed it, please give us a thumbs up, and we'd love to hear your comments and hear how your garden is growing at this time of the year.
Well, where are we going next?
Next, we'll go inside in the inner courtyard of our front yard.
Oh, cool. Here are the geese flying over.
Yep.
Connect with us on YouTube.